Yo, yo.
What up, what up, what up? You know what time it is, baby. None That Certificial Podcast.
You all ready?
Yeah, it's your boy Philly.
And it's your boy C.
Yeah, once again, Sunday, 6 p.m. Thank y'all for tuning in. If you missed any of the past shows, please go through our archives, like, subscribe, and share them joints.
Yeah, and if you watch them shits again.
Yeah, man, rerun them, motherfuckers. Get them numbers up, man.
You all ready?
Shout out to the subscriber, man. We appreciate y'all, man, for real, though.
No, but seriously, if you want to support the channel, you know what I mean? Like, subscribe, you know what I mean? Turn them notifications on, you know what I mean? Help with the algorithm.
Algorithms.
Yeah, that part.
Yeah, that part.
Yeah, get that up.
Yeah, man, so you know, we back in the building. See, I got my brand new Now That Certificial joint.
About time, nigga.
Yeah, about time, right? Make sure y'all get y'all's too, man. Where can they follow us at? They want to get some shirts and all that.
Oh, Certificial Clothing Company on Instagram, man.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, just DM, you know what I mean? We'll get at you.
That's what it is, man. Support the brand, baby.
You already.
But we here, man. It's always a pleasure and shit. You know, what's good with you, see? How was your week, man?
Man, tough, man.
It was
hot,
tough.
Motherfucker, man.
Yeah, definitely was hot, man.
Yeah, in that sweatbox, man. I'm working my ass off all week.
All motherfucking week.
You already.
Doing what the fuck we do. Figuring out a week. Take over the world like Pinky and the Brain. Me being the brain and all.
You Pinky and the Brain.
Nah, man.
I'm the world.
Yeah, man. But you know, it's a good thing to be back here, man, doing what we do, man. You know. And we was rapping before we got on air and all that.
Right.
Earlier we was talking about a few things, you know, first impressions, old niggas who can't let go of the past.
Nah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yo got them hot.
All types of fly shit.
Yo hot.
You know me, man.
No hot ball boy.
Always in the new whip, probably fucking the latest rapper's bitch. You know what I'm saying?
Bluffing.
Nah, man, but what's good, man?
What's up, man? Talk to me.
You know, there's a lot of shit on the table. We was talking about first impressions earlier. You know, from a male perspective and a female perspective, every time you meet somebody, you always meet the interview version of that person. You never really know a motherfucker till you know a motherfucker. It might take some time, it might not take you a lot of time, but you know, what first impressions mean to you, bro?
I mean, first impressions mean a lot. But at the same time, you can't just go off the first impression all the time though.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Because depending on where you at that moment,
mm-hmm.
that could throw the whole vibe off, you know what I'm saying? But
yeah.
You know, if you ain't in a fly move, you know what I mean? A motherfucker, you just like, you know what I'm saying? You trying to get away from a motherfucker, so you ain't really giving a motherfucker a fair shot.
Yeah, yeah,
you know
yeah.
What I mean? But,
yeah.
What'd you really say?
No, I was going to say that. Sometimes, especially, all right, speaking for women, they always fall in love with that interview nigga. But then a few months down the road, she might see some shit that might be a few red flags. And, you know, she'll try to look over that shit because she chasing that interview version of that person that first couple of weeks, the first month, or whatever, you know what I mean? And she'll look over the bullshit, you know what I mean? And accept a lot of shit. Not saying that she shouldn't, because, you know, if you're going to love a person, you accept every aspect of that person, you know what I mean? My thing is sometimes we need, as a people, need to chill. We're falling in love with that interview person. Or falling in life, or whatever emotion, you know what I mean, that you gravitate to and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I agree and I kind of disagree.
Mm-hmm.
Because, just because you love a motherfucker, you say you're supposed to, you know what I'm saying, love every, you know, every part of that person.
Mm-hmm.
But if you truly love somebody, you're supposed to be pushing yourself to be the best you possible.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta be able to reflect, be able to look in the mirror and be like, you know what I mean, I gotta change some of this shit, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So, at the end of the day, you know what I mean, I feel you on the aspect where as though, baby, I love you, even if nothing changes, I still love you,
mm-hmm.
you know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, you want a motherfucker to be there,
yeah.
best gun, you know
yeah,
what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? It's all about the elevation type of thing, right? And sometimes you can get caught in the past and shit. And forget to elevate, and that's how I think how a lot of relationships become stale, because motherfuckers be stuck in that one, living for that moment. Because it's like a crackhead, you hit that one rock that first time, you be chasing that high forever and ever and ever and ever and never come back. You know what I'm saying?
Like,
I mean, I wouldn't know. You would though. You know what I'm saying, Poop?
Never hit no rocks, man.
No ready rocks over here, man.
But yeah. I mean, first impression, not only just with in relationships with females, you know what I'm saying? Just prayer. You know what I mean? I've been like we were saying earlier, like I've been in the circumstances where though you know, you prejudge a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Just because of their demeanor. You know what I mean? You end up being your man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It's kind of like us and shit. Like, we hated each other and shit.
Yeah, I still hate them, but
yo, like, you know what I mean? Some of my best friends in the world were niggas I didn't like from the jump. Like, I'm saying, and you can relate to that shit too, yeah. Right? Yeah. You know what I mean? Some of the best niggas, people in the world that's around you, you didn't start off like that. And I'm sure y'all know some people like that too. Like, y'all was either at each other's head, pause, you know what I mean? Everybody felt like, and it's thundering outside, man. Yeah,
storming out that motherfucker.
Yeah, BG&E, y'all better keep this on, that bill paid. You know what I'm saying?
You already.
But, yeah, you know what I mean? What was I lost my train of thought that fast.
I don't know, you was talking to the people though, saying they know somebody, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah, you know some people that you didn't like from the beginning, and then y'all end up turning out to be best buddies or whatever, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, especially and, with females. Females yeah. On females.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Bitch, I hated you, you know what I mean?
Bitch, I ain't fuck with you, and you thought you was cute. Mm-hmm. You had on the new blip-flops and the jammies.
Whole time you thought she was cute.
Yeah, and that be it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's why a lot of, and that's another thing too. I ain't gonna skip off, but I might, if I remember, I'll bring that back up. But, yeah, you know, some of your best people you thought was your enemy end up being your best friends and shit. So sometimes we need to give people a chance, you know, because we once again, we fall in love with the interview version of that person. And then when they show us another side, it's like, how the fuck you gonna be book smart, but you dumb smart? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And you thinking, because we set expectations up against people, like unknowingly, like we like, yeah. Man, you know what I mean?
I mean, and you gotta stand it, as you should. You know what I'm saying? And it's kind of hard not to have expectations for a motherfucker. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You can motherfucker say shit all the time, but it's to not have no expectations for a motherfucker is kind of useless. Like, why the fuck would I go into a situation and not expect nothing from you?
Right. My thing
is, sometimes I expect motherfuckers to be like me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I expect motherfucker to keep it real with a motherfucker, cause I just think that's just how. You know what I mean? Grown men operate. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's deserving. Yeah. But you know, every circumstances call for different measures, right? Like, your circumstance coming up was way harder than most motherfuckers probably would have been. Whereas though you've been,
I had a good upbringing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's perspective, because I look at it, I take it for what it is. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I take it for what it is, and it is what it is. Like, it's one thing when you in it.
Mm-hmm.
You don't look at it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It's like being in the hood and motherfuckers shooting and motherfuckers dying every day. You're not really looking at it like a motherfucking person in the suburbs.
Right. You know what I'm saying?
Because you win it.
Crazy.
Yeah. You win it. You used to lose the motherfuckers, you know. So, it's just, it is what it is. When you win it, you win it. You know what I mean? Yeah. It takes for you to step out. You know what I mean? Take a step back and then, you know what I mean? Look at it from the outside in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man, that perspective is everything, dog. You know what I mean? And that's even coming to religious joints when motherfuckers, like, you know what I mean? Somebody who might go to church every week, you see him every Sunday, but then you might catch him on a Thursday and they on some freak wild shit. And you, man, how the fuck you supposed to be X, Y, and Z? And you doing, we kind of put people on pedestals when people are human. There are many layers to me. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
As a person and shit. And some of the layers you might not like. Some of the layers you might, yo, that's cool, yo. You should stick to that. But I don't think nobody's one way. And we shouldn't be. You know what I mean? I just think putting on the table, let a nigga know what you is so they won't make those judgments or, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Whatever and shit.
And that's how I come to the table. Like, in a relationship, even, like, I lay my shit out. You know what I mean? Because you going, it ain't gonna take long for you to know it.
Mm-hmm.
So I laid my shit out all the months.
So the dating scene is still the relationship scene.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, I think I kind of come on too strong. I give way too much out in the beginning. Because I'm like me, I put everything on the table, like, except not to accept it or not. Or to put it out there as like, man, well, you gotta roll with this if you wanna roll with me. No, because I know everybody ain't fit for that shit.
Yeah. I'm kind of like what you said, though. I'm kind of like accept it or don't. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
But you don't think that's wrong?
Because I know I'm not for everybody. Mm-hmm. And I'm all right with that. You know what I'm saying? I'm all right with that. I'm all right that you don't, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Or you too this, or you too that, or you not enough this. All right. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man.
You just not for me.
I feel you, though. I feel you. You can't make everybody love you and like you and shit.
Yeah.
Even as much as we all want it, everybody ain't gonna like you. Everybody ain't gonna love you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's for sure.
And some people might just love you like, man, I go for such and such, X, Y, and Z. But yeah, man, Nana Certificial, man, you know what I mean? That's the kickoff of the junk, you know what I mean? First impressions. Are they the last impressions? I doubt they very are, because you learn something motherfucking next week, you'd be like, nah, that's the impression. This nigga's a dickhead.
Mm-hmm.
This, or shorty, she a fucking nut. You know what I mean? Yeah, man.
What else we got going?
There's all types of shit, you know what I mean? I watched a couple joints this week. I watched a couple interviews this week with some people who can't let go of the past and shit. And I hate that. That's like a nigga coming home from 40 years. Well, let's say 10 years. That's extreme. 10 years, and he come back to the block and think that's still his block. Boss, this block done flipped 6 times since you done been gone.
Right.
You ever run into a nigga like that? Come on, man, nigga, you know I had it back in 96, man. Niggas was getting it. You know what I mean? Y'all niggas wasn't even on the porch. But them little niggas that was on the porch, them niggas in the streets.
Man.
Really living that shit. And they don't go by them same code and ethics as that particular party might be going through these days. You know what I mean? I seen a joint with rap nigga. I ain't gonna say his name and shit. He feel like he owed something. Like, he put the battle scene. Nigga, first off, the first...
Who the fuck is it?
I don't like saying niggas' names, because niggas be thinking I'm a hater and shit. See? Okay. You know what I mean? I know he out of towner and shit.
Okay.
You know what I mean? You just watch the Queens flip shit. Y'all might... And I don't mean to just be sending traffic over there. Flip, send us some motherfucking traffic. But just watch this shit. You might see shit. But, you know, in particular, it just reminded me of niggas who always be holding on and shit like you owe something. You ain't owe shit in this world. Niggas don't remember nothing you did in life except what you did yesterday. That's it.
Yeah. What have you done for me lately?
Yeah, what have you done? You perfect, nigga. What have you done for me lately? That's what it is out here, man. Niggas don't remember shit, man. You feel me? And if you ain't transitioning and moving on to another platform, then you're gonna be stuck, and you're gonna be bitter, and you're gonna be angry, and you're gonna be keep chasing this fucking dream that you don't
you
fucking
sound
live.
Mad, yo.
I did. Right. I don't mean to sound like that, cause I transition. Y'all niggas see me. You don't see me out here rapping on stage and trying to battle niggas and what the fuck I look like at my age doing some goofy shit like that, man. Like, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get with the young nigga. Young nigga knock you the fuck out, yo. You know what I mean? Knock you smooth out. You stuck, but yeah, whatever. Don't live in the past, nigga. Get this cash. You know what I mean?
All right.
Yeah, see, what's up, man? You got me sipping on this motherfucking Hendo rock.
Now, you usually do that clear shit.
Yeah, I usually do the clear shit. You got me on a darky this week, man.
Mm-hmm.
Pause.
My cup was asking what was in my cup last week. That was lemonade and Henny.
Lemonade and Henny. It's cool. It tastes pretty good. I like ginger on the Henny, though.
Yeah, that too.
Yeah, that's pretty good, right?
I can do anything with Henny.
All the ladies, they like that motherfucking strawberry Henny and shit. You gotta have some sweet shit to they shit.
Mm-hmm.
Motherfucking, Hennessy don't make a bottle of that strawberry shit. That shit tastes like syrup.
Yeah, niggas making that, selling that.
Yeah, they selling, they loving that shit. Shout out everybody out there who bartending on the side and shit, you know what I mean? Making drinks and shit, because it be hot as shit out this summer and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all need some love, dog. I need to be around the party, dog. I feel like Mitch, man, paid in full, man.
Yeah, you ain't gonna be able to fuck around with that Rona.
Yeah, I know, right? Cases is flying high now with the Rona shit, man. That shit crazy, man. They gonna shut this bitch down again.
Yeah, I think they was talking about that shit.
Yeah, they talking about the whole shit or just like certain shit?
I think certain shit, like eating restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
Shit like that.
Dang, just when I was about to take you out to the 4-star 5 joint, you know what I mean? Roof crib. They fucked it up. Save some real niggas some money and shit now. Shit, order that shit off Grubhub or something.
What the fuck? You were saying something earlier, man. You were saying something about you were talking about that Megan Thee Stallion shit.
Oh yeah, that's crazy, right? You know what I mean? Like, you know, shout out to my man Tory Lanez. You know what I mean? I hope it don't go bad.
They trying to sign a petition to
lock him up. Yeah, put him back to Canada and shit.
Can you deport a nigga to Canada?
Yeah, it's not part of the United States, is it? It's not part of the United States. It's definitely part of North America, but it's not a part of.
Nah, damn. Well, no, a nigga can't go over there.
Who?
A lot of motherfuckers can't.
Yeah,
a lot of fuck up, you can't get across
that. Felonies and type shit like that. But remember though, when you catch a felony here, you do get deported if you're from another country. If you're not from here, I mean,
not all felonies though. They got
a lot of major. Like violent crime. Yeah, violent crime definitely gonna get sent over the border. Head to the border. You forgot your boarding pass. That's fucked up, dog. Yo, he supposedly shot
him. That's my guy, though.
I fuck with him. I ain't got nothing bad to say about Tory Lanez. I'm going to tell you, if I had a big old goofy bitch beating on my black ass and I had to chop her, fuck! Oh! Damn, bitch! You know what I mean? Yeah. But, you know.
Yeah, we ain't, you know what I mean? We can't advocate the violence.
Yeah, you can't. I'm not advocating it, but I'm just saying.
No, and I feel what you're saying, though. Yeah. Like, I don't know. I wasn't there, so I can't really speak on it.
I don't know neither, man. And man.
You know, motherfucker always going to speculate and make it seem like yo was in the wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know what I mean, a nigga that was the aggressor just because he was the man.
Yeah.
She might have been punishing Shaw.
Punishing him. I know them hands big as a bitch, too. You know, I know she was knocking him with her left and her right.
Yeah, get well soon, though.
Yeah, get well soon, Shorty. Man, stay out the way, man. Keep getting your money. Keep being beautiful. Because I've been riding with you, man, since 2017 when nobody in Baltimore really knew who the fuck you was. I played you on the show. I played your music and all that shit. You know what I mean? No dickie. You know, I'm just saying, like, I really liked her and shit. You know, I thought she had skills. And it's sad to see her put in this predicament where she catch a bullet or something.
Niggas trying to send you. I will never sign no petition to send you.
Yeah, I'm not going to sign. And you dumbass niggas, don't do that. But you know what fucked me up, see? The moment that gray line get crossed when it come to women, they want the hoes to rally up and ride on niggas. But you don't know the full story, and people do that.
Mm-hmm.
People hear half of the story and have real conversations because they are real situations, like that situation this week. You sent me the video with the chick, the DNA test.
When the nigga said the baby one head?
Yeah. Everybody for the first 24 hours was like, man, fuck that bitch. She bit my bitch. Turns out the video ain't even fucking real, man.
Yeah.
But look how fast.
It got me, though.
Yeah, it got me, too.
It got me.
I was like, damn. I was like, about time we got that shit on camera because we don't see that.
Man, it was kind of greasy, too.
What'd he say? What'd he tell the bitch? Bitch, you got 30 days. He hit it like the rental.
He gave her 30 days?
He gave her 30 days. He said, you got 30 days, and you and that baby getting the fuck out my house. That's what he said. And she's sitting there like, no, but it's yours. I mean, she sold it, too. This lady's a fucking paid Hollywood actor.
But you going to get an Oscar, bitch.
Yeah, she should get an Oscar for that joint.
Come on, man.
Do Oscars give awards for YouTube and Instagram videos?
No, that bitch going to get a Slimmy, not an Emmy.
Slimmy, not an Emmy. That bitch definitely was. She talking about she want to go to Dubai for 2 weeks. Bitch, goodbye for every week.
Yeah, get a Mr. Goofy award.
Mm-hmm. Stupid shit, man. And people do anything in this day and age for likes and laugh. And what is a like worth? Like, what the fuck is a like worth?
They call clout chasers.
Yeah, right. Clout chasers and shit. When I first heard that through your boy Snitch 9, he started saying that clout shit. That when I first heard that shit.
Yeah. Well, I heard motherfuckers saying it, talking about him.
Yeah, most definitely. Yeah, definitely the king of the cloud chasers.
Yeah, like ain't worth nothing, man.
Yo, but today it is though, man. Like the money is not worth anything, but we put value on shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I see motherfuckers get a whole bunch of likes on social media and niggas see this bitch in real life. Man.
Yeah.
Don't like nothing about
it. Don't like nothing. That was slick as shit, yo. Don't like nothing about the bitch.
Don't like nothing about him.
And you dumbass niggas out here keep flexing and flashing on the ground so niggas get to robbing you on live.
Man, now you rob them. Police come.
Yeah, police. You know what I mean? How many niggas that got locked up off of the social media and shit?
And just telling them themselves.
Telling them themselves. I just seen a video the other day with a little young boy and shit. He was, told the exact story about him robbing a pizza man and shooting a pizza man. You's going to jail. There ain't nobody got to tell on you, nigga. And he got his niggas locked up inadvertently behind him. Say, yeah, bro, remember when you was in the car, when you had put the gas on, I shot him and I jumped in and you was like, damn. And I was like, speed. And I'm like, damn, you just sent your man to jail with you. You want some company?
Mm-hmm.
Breeze a fucking crowd.
Definitely got to sell some company.
Imagine when you got a cell buddy. You got four cell buddies instead of one. It's tight as a bitch in that motherfucker, man. Nigga's crazy, man. Stop doing that shit, man. Stop. Everybody want to be seen. I remember back in the day, remember Hard Copy and motherfucking E.T. and all that shit? And they used to show shit like that.
Hard Copy. Hell yeah.
Yeah, remember that shit? Nigga, the cameraman just was everywhere. You be, nigga be in the shower washing up, opening the joint. Oh, shit. You know what I mean?
With Joey Greco on your shit.
I miss Cheaters, yo. Bring back Cheaters and bring back my nigga Joey, man. Shout out my nigga Joey, yo.
Nigga stabbed Joey.
Yeah, he did get stabbed on the
boat. Mind your business, bitch.
Mind your business, bitch.
Yeah, fuck wrong with you.
Yeah, Joey, he was like,
hey, Them niggas goofy as shit though, man. Going down on niggas like, yo, don't do, like, the fuck is you doing, man? Mind your motherfucking business.
Could you imagine that shit?
That's high class nosy. Like, you just on some first class nosy shit. Like,
yeah, yo.
Man, don't blow my motherfucking spot, nigga. What are these cameras, man?
Big cameras, too, yo. It be.
You nigga be hurt when that shit happens.
I be sick. And you know what's crazy, CEO? Me and my wife used to watch that shit on a daily.
That shit still come on.
It do? On what channel would it come on? I don't know. I gotta check it. I'm gonna look at the reruns because there's some good ones out there.
He ain't on it though. Was a nigga.
Yeah, that was like phony ass nigga. Yeah. The Joey look like they got Steve up in that bitch. Steve Greco on that bitch, man. Old clown ass niggas, man. But, man. Could you imagine niggas running down on you with the you get the table chopping up, work with your bitch with the titties out, and you know we gonna get it. Doors kick open, you think it is the ATF.
Right.
Whole time it's Joey with the camera. Niggas should have been smoking them niggas, man.
And what was your doing, yo? Yeah. I always run down all day in the restaurant. Niggas be goofy.
And
shit.
What was you doing last night?
Hey, mind your fucking business.
Fuck you mean what I was doing, nigga?
My business. He be acting like he's showing up with her, like, this is my business. She wants to know why. Nigga, if you don't get the fuck out of my
goofy bitch. And then you want to do a motherfucking testimonial in between. So yeah, he told me that he loved me, and he had bitch. How much more red flags do you got to see to know that the nigga cheating on you? You knew he was cheating on you.
Yeah, bitch, want to see that on camera though.
I got to see it for my own eyes.
You see?
You see now, bitch got judging dick out. Shit over the table. Oh no, it ain't what it seems.
It ain't what it looks like.
It's TV, man. This is TV, man. Yo.
That's why I never go through a bitch's phone, yo. I can never go through a woman's shit, yo.
Yo, be sick. You'll be sick if you do.
Yo,
they
I
slick
never,
now, though.
Because I never want to. I don't ask questions that I don't want to know the answer to.
Man,
and I don't look for shit I don't want to see. You know what I mean?
That's
bitch can cheat on me easy.
Easy.
You know what I mean? Because it got to be right in my face.
Yeah.
Because I'm just be good at it. Just don't get caught.
Don't get caught.
Yeah.
You get caught, I'm gonna burn this bitch the fuck down.
Hey.
You had one time with me, baby.
Hey. That's I ain't gonna be looking. Like, you gonna do, you mean do you, but be good at it.
You got me that one time. That, you was good. You were good. You know some shit. You got me that one time and shit. But that shit never happened again because you got to be quicker than that.
But speaking of bitches, or niggas, but females in particular, man, seeking attention.
Oh.
I've been seeing a lot of motherfucking, a lot of my homegirls, a lot of chicks on my timeline getting their bodies done.
Yeah, I've been seeing a lot of work. I know a couple chicks talking about some Gary going to the knife. This is what I don't understand. You ready to spend between 5 and 10 racks to get a new rack or a new ass. Like,
you still the same person.
You still the same piece of shit you was before you got cut. You feel me, Smurf looking bitch? You still the same goofy bitch that was out there looking slushing through the city.
Hey.
Now you got some titties and you want niggas to be like, damn, that's not what, that's why, and bitches kill me. You,
cause they think that's, they think that's all niggas see.
Yeah, they
think that's
stupid.
What niggas want. They dumb as shit.
Stupid.
Cause that's all you bringing to the table, bitch, a bunch of fake shit.
Fake
now
shit.
Now you walk down the street dragging that wagon. Goofy as shit, dumb ass walk. Bitch, what'd you say the bitch had?
Hey,
bitch, you still got scoliosis.
Bitch still got the hunch in her back with scoliosis and shit. But now her butt big, now she walked to that bitch. Yeah, look at me. Bitch, you keep hitting niggas with the angle joints.
Hey,
bitch, you step, you turn
the angler.
Yeah, the angler.
Bitch, you should be a fisherman. Bitch, you are an angler.
Yo, what you said earlier, it is high. The angler.
Yeah, like it, for real.
Look at
when you see her in person, bitch, right. Like this shit.
Yeah, bitch. And yo, you know what's
bitch,
crazy?
Bitch, angle game crazy.
Yo.
Bitch got cameras on her ceiling.
It's real live shit, though.
Man.
Bitch hit you with the, and she in the back. You know some of the big bitches, you know I love y'all sexy big girls out there, too. But you know some of the little sloppy Jones, they hit you with the angle. They don't take no shots from bottom, no, nothing under the titties. That's how I know that you a catfish, bitch, because you all you keep giving me is this angle, and you squeezing them together.
I seen that bitch at the aquarium.
Yeah.
Catfish, bitch.
Catfish, man. I don't like no motherfucking catfishing and all that shit. Man, these bitches out here, they, on the gram, I'm looking, I said, I know she got a big old crazy situation under there.
Man, not even just them.
And it's not a problem, because I don't mind.
I just see a motherfucker. And then when you know a motherfucker, it's one thing when you like you know a motherfucker, but then you see him on the ground, you be like, I know niggas be going for this.
Going for that shit, man. She be selling that shit.
Slew footed, bitch.
Slew footed, bitch. Keep knocking over trash cans and shit, cause you keep sliding your feet, man. shit wild to me though. Listen, I'm gonna tell you, ladies, man, stop that goofy shit. We don't have, y'all don't read the magazines no more. I'm glad, because y'all used to really live by that. Like, guys want a sex sell, and you industry niggas keep telling bitches, oh yeah, sex sells. You gotta be a old titties out, ass popping, and talk about sucking shit off. Man, you ain't got to be like that. And then y'all get mad. Bad bitches all. This is the bad bitch go to right here. Oh, you gonna fuck that big nasty bitch? Because it don't take much for a nigga to get wet. You know what I mean? It don't take much. And y'all doing all of this facade, all of this makeup. I know a chick who don't never take her makeup. My man never probably even seen her with her makeup off, y'all. And that's sick.
For real?
That's sick, y'all.
Fuck, you fuck with Ronald McDonald?
No, man.
That's funny, motherfucker. I ain't never seen with no makeup. No fuck with Ronald. Free Ronald, man. God damn.
Free Ronald McDonald, yo.
Got Ronald McDonald on the
No,
cuff.
But you don't gotta be doing that. Like, bitch would be like looking crazy, look like a whole Nestle Crunch bar, yeah, without the makeup. Then you,
yeah, take a makeup off, bitch, like 50 Cent in the face.
Straight like that, yo. Come out that bitch looking like Naomi Campbell or some shit. And you like, damn, yo. They'll put the fixture. Like, imagine if niggas put the makeup on every day and come out looking like, you know what I mean?
Right. They be doing shit, making their nose look slimmer.
That's how you do that. Y'all work magic
how
with that shit.
How you learn that? That's like a nigga in jail. Yeah. You just learning shit.
Yeah, learning, sitting home. I'm a, shit, fuck it. I ain't got the money to get it. I'm just going to slap a whole bunch of baby powder on my shit. And that's when you know she look, yeah, like a
bitch shit. Face tan, that motherfucking neck black. But shout out to y'all, man.
Shout out to y'all, man. Do y'all think.
Shout
whatever
out to
y'all
foundation.
Foundation, ass.
Foundation strong. Hey, it is what it is. That just ain't my motherfucking cup of tea.
It ain't my cup of tea even, bitch. I like a regular bitch, man. I like a bitch who just naturally pretty, you know what I mean?
Give me a beautiful regular degler all day.
A regular day. You ain't got to keep throwing on makeup and eyelashes and shit. Bitch, eyelash touch look like a whole broom joint in front of us. Baby, you know you wasn't even born like a baby.
It's like every bitch got the same bitch on their wall. They all trying to look like the same bitch.
I don't know where she at. The whole time she a piece of shit.
Beyonce. Anybody want to be Beyonce?
Yeah, that's just sickening, man. Keep watching these IG models.
Even Jay tired of her.
Jay, I know you tired of hitting that ass, man. Look, all the bitches.
He might not be tired of
that.
But he probably like. He got I'm going to this wing of the house, bitch. You hear me? You leave me alone.
Right.
You know what I mean?
West wing ass bitch, man. Stay over there. But you know it's crazy because you ain't got to do all that, man. And you niggas are sad too. Y'all keep flexing with the cash. And y'all the ones geesing these chicks up. Big old bricks of money and shit. Bitch say,
yo, that's Amazon money, man.
That's Amazon.
Be buying
you order
that
money. Shit,
yeah.
Real shit, you gonna order money.
All that shit don't be real, man.
Do not.
They be faking, man.
Stand right in front of the Lambo like, yeah, you know, just a birthday gift. It's a birthday present and shit. You know what I mean? Bitch, this ain't no thing. You gotta take
that
bitch
back. Who ain't been in front of a Lambo or a Bentley or some shit like that?
But that shit just be bait, though, bro. Like, chicks and niggas, they just be baiting motherfuckers in. Then soon as you get behind, you see the facade. You like, oh, this nigga a fraud the whole time. He a fluke, man.
He didn't already put that dick in.
He didn't already gave that dick down, man, that dick tackler shit. You know what I mean? Too late
too
now.
Late, baby. And you gonna talk grease about him, right? He done already wore you out. Mm-hmm. Nigga ain't shit. Yeah.
Don't talk bad about him.
I know I ain't. Wore you out, though.
Wore your dumb ass out. Had you up there a whole week hitting a ham sandwich, bitch. Don't watch this shit, because I'm going to make you mad. Because I started to say some shit, man. Henny must be kicking in and shit.
Talk
to him. Anyway, no, I ain't going to do him like that, man. I'm trying to get some head later on or something. Bitch, you going to give me something, bitch. I definitely ain't hitting the raw dog, though. I'm going to hold on to that. You won't punish me. Anyway.
What's up, man?
What's up, yo?
Man.
Oh, look, this is fraud, man. Stop selling that. Motherfuckers be selling that fucking blow up, man. Just be you, man. You ain't got to be all that. When is being you gonna become pretty enough? And when is being you gonna become real enough? You know what I'm saying?
Man.
Real, man. I don't know, but we really shit on. We certificial over here.
You
we certified
know,
with this lifestyle.
It's only so long, fake thugs can pretend.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. So it's only been so long.
Come to the dark will come to light.
Come to the fucking light. And y'all know this, 2020 is hindsight. Everybody been seeing everything come to the light. So all that fraud and faking you doing, that shit gonna come off of them sheets at night. You know what I mean? So just be you, man.
Your whole face be on the pillow.
Yeah, yes, sir. Right. Oh, pillow is the face.
Hey, you talk like this. Look at the pillow.
Yeah, get the fighting and flexing on, bitch. Man, shit crazy. Just be you, man. It's okay to be beautiful. It's okay to be you. beautiful. You ain't gotta be extra. It's okay, dude. You still a man, homie. If you ain't got the whip outside and the big nine of money and you working and you doing what you gotta do, you still real too. That's respectable, bro. Yeah,
absolutely.
You know what I mean, don't change for nobody. It's Certificial Podcast. Y'all know what it is, man. Follow us on the IG and all other platforms and make sure y'all questions for me. Yeah, when can I start? You know what I mean? Get at the job. 2 weeks in, man, I hate this bitch, man. Show up late. You know what I mean? You stealing from the locker room and the refrigerator. You keep showing up late. You ain't even reached the probational period yet. You done fucked all that shit up. You done had 20 write-ups. I be hating niggas, man. Look at your man. Yo, niggas look sick, yo. That nigga like he working in a bowling alley, yo. That's why I tell you niggas, you keep fronting and frauding, yo. You gonna be taking tickets and giving shoe sizes out, nigga. Dumb motherfucker. Damn, Meek, what's up, Meek? Man, they say Meek fucked that Milano money up, even though he put her on. I know you sick. She was plain Jane anyway. She was cool, though. She was cool, though. Motherfucker cool, G. I liked it.
Oh, yeah.
Fair for a square wouldn't take her nowhere, but she cool.
No, she cool.
She was cool, though. She is a mogul. See, the thing I like about Milano is
She had her shit together. She was motivated.
You can't never let go of... You niggas is dumb. You young niggas is so dumb. Y'all niggas give up the whole 80 for that 20. You gotta do the 80-20 rule, bro. If she bringing shit to the table, is she making a table? Keep her. Cheaper to keep her. Say you got another baby on the way, though, man. I hope not. Sick.
For real?
Yeah, they said that's why she broke up. They broke up, broke it off, because he got another chick pregnant.
You know what I mean? Oh, somebody else. I ain't hear that.
Yeah, I heard it today, dog. I was like, damn, Meek, I hope say it ain't so, man.
You tell me that.
Tell me something. Me and her, we gonna remain friends. What bitch you know you done had a baby about? We gonna remain friends and raise the kids up.
Yeah, that's baby, friend, bitch ain't. Baby 2 weeks old.
Yeah, you done fucked up some money somewhere. That's what that is. Trying to duck that child support and shit, man. For real, man. That's why I tell you niggas, man. You young niggas keep thinking y'all know it all, man. These gray hairs ain't coming from nothing, man. You feel me?
I'm a shit boy.
Keep your fucking job.
Don't say you're working a motherfucker. Bowling
alley, man. That motherfucker asked, who ordered the nachos? Damn, yo. That you, yo? Hey, Justin, that you, yo? Damn, kid. That's crazy.
Yo, the motherfucking headband on.
Headband, man. Hair all over his
head. Like he got his head pushed back like the girl type headband jump.
Couldn't even get the shape up. You know, niggas was getting shape ups every week in the locker room. Shout out my man, Berto Blazem, too, man. Y'all niggas need to cut. Holler at him. He on Instagram somewhere. But, man, you niggas, that's why I tell you niggas, keep getting, just why you know a nigga, when you know a real nigga, when you'll know a nigga when he get some money. When a nigga get money, that's who they show you who they really is, because it heightens everything that's fucked up about them.
Yeah, it heightens everything that's good about them, too.
Yup, everything that's good.
And everything that's bad.
Everything that's bad. You niggas is laid back at one when you got the job.
And when a nigga don't need you no more.
Yeah, you see who you really like is. That,
that's all it is.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. Stay true to yourself, man. That's the moral of today's episode is stay true to yourself. Be your best you. Be the Certificial brand of you. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what we had, man. It's me and my man, motherfucking Cee. We did this shit from the muscle, out the mud. You know what I mean?
That's what we do, though, man.
Yeah, man.
Now this shit, man. I have been crying in this picture.
Yo, you still
yo look
sick.
Crazy, man.
Yo, you look this sick, yo.
Yeah, man. I'm tired of saying niggas looking bad, man.
Yeah, man. You
boys
niggas
ride past the Jiffy Mo on the bike.
Who? Oh, J-Rock? Oh, I didn't mean to say your name. My man look like he fucking with the Rock, though. ROC, baby.
Yo, Jay Grizzle.
Yo, but you notice every time somebody, every time somebody leave the job and shit, they always look fucked up. They be dying to get back in. Man, holla at the people, man. Tell them I got my shit together. They be on some Eddie Kane Dang shit. Dang, remember me youngin'.
I still got it.
Nah, baby, you ain't got to take this 20, man. Get yourself together. I don't need your money. Look at me. Nice like this. Yo, but look, it's not that Certificial Podcast. You about to get the fuck up out of here, man.
Already, man.
Y'all niggas stay tuned to the program. We doing this shit. We literally changing the narrative when it comes to this game.
You already,
we bringing ourselves and ain't going to bring nothing else but us. You feel me? Tune in next week, 6 p.m. YouTube. Fuck with the gang, man. It's your boy Philly, man.
Mm-hmm. And it's your boy C, man.
And you know what
like,
that is.
Comment, subscribe, man. Peace.
Yeah, now that's Certificial.